Hey everybody, the Banga's back. Welcome to part 15 of Let's Play Brain Lord, brought to you by GameAnyone.com. If you're wondering about that sprite on the right, yes, that is Samurai, the one that will revive me whenever I die, provided he has actual levels above 1. If he doesn't, then he can't revive me anymore. Let me go check out the library for now. Oh, Banga, would you like some tea? I'm finally finished decoding the silver plaque. Yeah, it took you long enough. You know how long I've been in the damn ice castle? The character... what? ...are faded and hard to read. When I checked it against the others, I found some amazing things. This is what it says. Long ago, a demon king controlled this world. The day the dragon was born, the demon king returned to the darkness. When the dragons died, demon king returned to this world. Yeah, apparently ancient civilizations did not understand proper grammar either. I wonder if there are clues about the dragon here somewhere. Long ago, Round from Arx used to talk about dragons. He has traveled all over the world. He might know something. Why don't you ask him? I would, but he locked himself in the back room. And I really have no reason to scan through the entire library. Because there are many vicious monsters around the Abel Ruins, a thorough investigation has never been made. All I know is that the puzzles there are a pain in the ass. That's not what it said on the book, that's what it should be on the book. Not interested in science and sorcery either. I'm just checking to see if there are any treasure chests. If you want to understand the lore of this game, you can check out the library. But I'm pretty sure half of it might be flavor text. That will have no impact on the game whatsoever. Actually, scratch that, 100% of that would be flavor text. That being said, I did sell off my excess armor, including the shields that I don't use. Well, given how much quality they have. I don't want to get rid of this fire sword because it could be useful moving on. Rather than just, like, use the whole path, I'm just gonna warp to Arx. And then before I leave Arx, I'll just buy some more of these warp gates. It's always a good idea to have a massive influx of them. If I keep Samurai at a decent level, I may not need reviving mirrors. And the phone rings. God damn it. Be right back. Okay, I'm back. Let's head over to the school. Yeah, the phone's on the charger because apparently the battery was completely drained. Hey, can I talk to Round? Otherwise I'll bash you with this mall. This is not much of a home, really. Well, where is he hiding to? Is he still in here? Oh, I can actually get in. For some reason, it's unlocked. I don't know why. He's like, did you beat the ice castle yet? Yeah? Come on in. It's been a long time, Banga. You're going to meet the dragon? Well, you know that the dragon protects the world, and is hiding at Droog Mountain. Do you know that the dragon has something to tell you? Long ago, I, too, went out with a friend looking for the dragon. My friend went to do research, but I only went to find riches. Then I began to realize the importance of my friend's work. The power had begun to weaken, and the shadow world was disappearing. I recognized my foolishness, and vowed not to let others make the same mistake. When I took the sapphire from the Droog statue, the road to the Shadow World was closed. Is this sapphire what you're looking for? Take this at once to Droog. Okay, I got the sapphire. The dragon's lifespan is probably short. Well, Dovahkiin's around after all, and well... maybe I'll get to the Shadow World and revive Joey and the whole gang before they get sucked away by America. Oh wait, wrong game. Never mind! Wrong universe, really. Okay, now would be a good time to head back to the shop and buy some more warp gates. Remember, I don't need any healing items, because, you know, I got Ceres and all. I'll put her to good use. Okay, buy some more warp gates. I should definitely buy three more? Counting, well, the three I got now, so I don't have to buy any more. I should definitely buy, like, a couple antidotes. And in case I have to deal with numbness in here as well, I'll buy a K-Burp. Okay, there's no real reason for me to actually just use the warp gate to go back to Toronto and work my way up. because the Droog statue is actually closer to Arx than it is to Toronto. So I'll use that. Okay, still takes like 2 hits to dispose of these enemies. That's a bit disappointing, but I'll live with it. We can't all be super powerful after all. I have to rely on Rowan pretty much. Okay, if I remember correctly, the statue's over here. Now that I got the Sapphire... Oh, which for some reason is green. When you put the Sapphire into the Droog statue, a strange voice came from somewhere. Close your eyes. I will lead you. In the name of Droog, whose spirit lights the world, take him to the sealed world, which holds the dragon's wing and the magic sword. Wait, I get another sword? Well, it didn't take long for that, fire sword to be completely useless! Okay, so we got some new enemies to deal with, just like those winged guys that act like the vultures from Zelda. You know, in the desert. Ooh, I almost got shot by an arrow. Okay, just a bunch of black wyverns, it seems. No, I think I just go all the way to the left. And then just work my way back up again. If I remember this place. Music sounds a bit catchy, I must admit, for a very dark-looking mountain that's very desolate of all life except demons. I expected something a little darker. But I like this theme. I don't think I should be going this way. Gotta find a way to get upward. Maybe I have to go down even further, or did I reach the wall of this place? Let me go all the way down, just to be sure. Okay, something tells me I probably missed something important. Might be a cave somewhere? Let's take a look around the whole mountain wall. Okay, I'm taking a staggering amount of damage. Maybe I should have Cerezo, not Samurai. Otherwise, I'll have no means to heal myself. I'll have a means to revive myself, but that'll cost Samurai a level. Okay, I'm not gonna worry about the whole jade pieces, because I can always just grind over at the Southern Path anyway. And there's an infinite source of that. Remember, I can't use the x-ray glasses because this is not a dungeon. This is technically an outside area. So I just gotta deal with any circling wyverns that come my way. I blocked that with my shield by accident, but that's cool, I guess. Okay, even though the enemy was dead, I still get hurt by it. That makes no sense. Well, the enemy is crashing into you upon its death, but still, come on, it's a SNES game. We don't really apply real life here. You can't apply real life to a game like this. Where you got fairies following you around, and wolves that shoot arrows at ya. Where's the realism there? But anyways, I guess I'm getting a bit too ahead of myself. Looks like I'm just heading back where I started. Yeah, I bet you I'm gonna go all the way back to that Droog statue again. Yep, I knew it. Where the hell was the goddamn cave? I think I have an idea on how I'm going to approach it, though. But it involves a major jump. Okay, I definitely see a cave over there. I gotta be able to make some jump. It involves, like, sticking around here. Do I go back to the right? I think I'm onto something. Oh, I was so close. Wait a minute, do I need the cape for this? I have an idea. So remember, I move faster. No, that still did not work, and I took a little bit more damage. Remember, my defense was 0 instead of, well, an extra 10. Okay, let's try going further up. So I think I missed something important. There might be another cave. Yep. For some reason, I didn't go this way. I thought I did go this way. I would have thought to go look over there. But apparently, I made an ass of myself by overlooking it completely. And these arrows do like 3 damage. What if there's another cave around here? No. So I guess I just gotta slide down that wall. Fair enough, I can do that. That's not a problem. I hope, at the very least. Yeah, I'm still sliding and I'm automatically in the cave. Logic! Okay, now this music is really dark. Oh, hi, Rocky. What's up? What is this? The Silent Stones. This stone has a will that opens a road only for those pure of heart. Those of you stopped on this road, don't give up. Keep trying. The road will open up to the one who is earnest. I have fairies. Does that make me earnest? I can be earnest. I burn! I'm earnest! No, that's awful. It looks like there's so many pathways, and this very room is so open, it's scary. What about that bridge we saw back in the entrance? Did it lead to any piece of treasure? I'm very curious. I'm surprised my shield is still around. At this rate, it would have just disintegrated by now. Oh, okay, well, really glad I came back, otherwise I'd have nowhere to save for the first part. Look, I found Droog 2. Where's Droog 1? Oh, I missed it. Cause I'm a dumbass. Okay, does it really matter what path I take? Cause there's like 4, pretty much. Oh, it's dark. You know what this means. I'm gonna have to give up my attack power. But I'm gonna need Colette to light up the place. She didn't get any use in the third dungeon, and now here we are. So apparently the mall will not protect me from numbness, it seems. That's very disappointing. So now I gotta deal with a bunch of rocks that I can't destroy. So what is this, a rock maze? Wait, a skull? Oh, it's a bomb. Okay. It's a freaking bomb. Oh, this must be the ice magic. Okay, I have a feeling it's gonna be very valuable. Given we're dealing with lava, after all. Oh, now we got palette swaps here as well for skeletons. Oh, the small skeletons. Big ones we haven't seen palette swaps of yet. Let's check the x-ray glasses for this very room. Okay, so it looks like there are 2 places to go. Like in the middle and in the far north. But there might be a treasure in the upper left. So that's why I'm going to check out the upper left first. And then we'll just come a little bit back to the right. Well, I didn't think there'd be a treasure, but I just wanted to clarify. Getting some experience I don't need. Stop going for the experience. You can't have it. You're already full. Please tell me Soros is not stuck. That's so embarrassing. Well, at least the bones won't hurt you when they're crumbled. Okay, is this going to take me to some different floor? Okay, it is. I don't want to go to a new floor yet. Instead, I want to check out that other way to the right. So if there's treasure there, that makes it all the better. Hey, wait, did the rock shift? For some reason, I'm trapped. Are the rocks actually just shifting? Like, if you go off screen, they just go into a different formation? OK, Okay, maybe I'm just seeing things. For some reason, I thought I was stuck. This place really doesn't make sense, it seems. Maybe I can't go that way unless I probably checked out the far right door. What's going on with these rocks? It seems like the formations change. I just have this nagging feeling that that's the case. For some reason, I thought I could get out. And I looked... Okay, never mind. I thought the formations changed yet again. But they do! I mean, look! I can't go as far to the right as I used to. Oh, this place is royally messed up if the rocks are changing on ya. I mean, look, now I can actually go here. Oh, right, that door's locked. How could I completely overlook that? Now I'm probably gonna have to be very arsed to find my way back to that door. I really should've practiced this place, I really should've. And Ceres is still stuck. Come on, woman, get yourself together. You have wings, use them. Fly over the rocks. Oh, look, we found the other safe one already. Okay, and there's even more of these rocks. Damn it. Oh, so we can't find any treasure chests here. I'm hoping not. This place would be totally messed up if you could. Okay, so it looks like there are three rooms or four rooms to look for in the central area. Let's try going all the way to the left. Okay, it looks like the left is completely out of option to me. Huh, maybe not. And I just suppose I can just use the magic missile on these jellyfish. I don't want to get stung by jellyfish, otherwise Ceres or Colette are going to have to pee on me to take out the venom. Oh wait, that sounds horribly wrong. Look, as soon as I hit them, I'm probably gonna get numbed. Or not. That's good with me. Oh my god. What if you get pretty much the worst formation where you get completely boxed in? Can you imagine if that happens? Like a formation that completely traps you and you have to use a warp gate? I mean, look, I'm trapped right now. I can't get out. Look at this. This is a totally messed up game mechanic to actually have that happen to you. Like, you can get trapped in here. So I have to use a warp gate. Oh my god, if this is what we gotta deal with, this is not gonna be a fun dungeon. And this is not because of, like, puzzles or anything. This is about raw luck. Luck that the random number generator doesn't give you a formation that boxes you in completely, forcing you to reset your game. Which, thankfully, we saved around here. Or do the formation change depending on where you walk? Could be a myriad of any situation, really. Like, I gotta think about how I'm gonna get to that room. Or at least go to the one that's down. Like, I don't know where this is gonna go. Well, I guess I'll have to go down here then. Check out this room. I'd like to get some treasure. Well, this is not what I was looking for, but I'll take it. A mountain like this could leave you dehydrated. But I guess I can work my way back to the upper left. Should be able to. I kinda hate that these jellyfish actually do track you, so they will follow you. That's commitment right there. They can move super slow and will go all the way just for you. That's dedication and commitment. Okay, did I shift any of the rocks? No. They're still boxing me in here. Who can deal with this? Did they even playtest this game? Especially at this point? Because you know you gotta deal with this crap. What if you get the worst formation known to man? I've reiterated this many times. This can't happen. In fact, it probably did. Forced me to use a warp gate. If I didn't have any, I'd have to reset. What if I was too absent-minded to save my game? I would have lost a lot of progress. Now, is there anything important here? It looks like we went down a floor. This could lead somewhere. If I miss a lot of treasure, I apologize, but what do you want me to do? I can't just know exactly where to go when rocks are just gonna block my way at random. I'm not Superman, you know. Then again, I don't think Superman'd be playing this game. He might have other standards, but that's just me. And I'm poisoned. Now we're back to the second floor. I don't think we're making any major inroads at all. So I bet you I'm gonna be going to many a locked door. What if I use ice? Okay, gets rid of the lava. And again, I can just skip across and use Ceres. Wait, is some of the floor just turning into lava? Yes, it is. That might force me to use my ice magic a lot. So, where am I going? Am I going to a room? So I'm seeing a lot of the floor breaking on me. I don't have a key, so I can't help you there. So this was the only room I could probably get into. And I have no key for it. Yeah, that's entirely the case. So, I'm gonna stop the video right here, and in the next part, I'm gonna continue scanning through this entire place, hoping to find where I need to go. See ya.